Now I get the red, which is pretty cool. And now we get a little cutscene. We're gonna have a little powwow. Yeah, let's just talk about our personal problems. Let's shoot the breeze. Pull some memory chips from the Mavericks. I analyzed them and found out that Doppler is trying to create a new battle body by collecting the quote special abilities in quote battle body. First, I thought Dr. Doppler was trying to create it for himself, but the information indicates that he will not be able to interface with it. It doesn't make any sense, but whatever. Can Sigma still be alive? Hidden laboratory has been pinpointed at point zero, I think it said. So, now we know where Dr. Doppler is. And we assume it's probably Sigma behind the whole thing. So now we gotta end it. End the conflict forever and ever. Let's see. I forgot all the names. I think I did. Yeah. Pretty sure I have everything. Now all I have to do is get the gold chip upgrade so that I have all the upgrades, and then I'll have 100%. I then just have to focus on beating the game, which is probably the hardest part. It's still way better. Like, you saw me collect all the items in the game, and it was still way easier than trying to collect even some of the items that I found in Mega Man X2. Just ridiculous, because at least you knew where a lot of the shit was. And stuff that wasn't obvious, well, you get the helmet upgrade and it'll tell you. So at least you know where to look. That was like an homage to X2 right here. I think it's the only part in the game that does this. Climbing that ladder like a boss. It's like a fist upgrades. Fuck you, man. I don't give a shit. I hate those things. I don't even want to fight them anymore. Bullshit. Here's the moment of truth. There was a battle junk robot, and now Zero has been completely useless up to this point. I've come to help you. I'll stop the collapsing ceiling, and you destroy the robot. Alright, that's a good enough deal, I guess. It's still collapsing, asshole. There's an army of powerful Mavericks in Dr. Dapper's lab. They've modified into war machines. He won't do anything. He's gonna scout around. He'll catch up to me later. Typical Zero being a completely useless douchebag. I wish I could be as useless and as cool as Zero when I grew up. That's the thing, like, we all love Zero. It's like our favorite character, right? But he doesn't do shit. He makes you do all the work. And even when he says he's doing stuff, there's no results. It was all you. It's like, I'll shut down the generator and maybe that'll help while you actually go kill the boss. That's fair. Alright, so I have to have full life or else this won't work. Don't ask me why. But that's just how it is. You have to have all full life, and you have to have all the upgrades in all the game. There's the hidden chamber. Sell this champ chip to enhance all your parts. The situation should be improved. You bet it is. And now, instead of getting the one crappy chip, I get upgrades to all of my shit. I get the gold armor, which now, I think the charge shot decreases weapon usage by half, so you have twice as much energy. I'm not sure. Yeah, I think that's how it works. And then helmet upgrade, which you wouldn't even notice based on the way I play, because I don't like standing still. But if you stand still, you will regenerate life. So that's pretty badass. And armor upgrade, I think it decreases damage by half again, so that you're only hit. Man, this P-Bomb sucks. A lot of the weapons in this game are fucking awesome, But, yeah, fucking open a door with my face. Love that shit. But the P-bomb is fucking bullshit. It's the most worthless piece of shit in this game. So, I've only fought this boss a couple of times. He's kind of hard. He was really hard the first time I fought him. Now, I got the upgrade for the armor, so I'm only taking 25% damage. But he still does a fuck ton of damage, even with that in mind. So here's what you gotta do. You have to shoot him with the drill right in the eyeballs, right in the forehead. And that little thing at the top of the screen hopping around will start dropping trash all over the place, including on your head. Meanwhile, he's trying to grab you with the claw. And sometimes he'll shoot acid at you. And sometimes little robots at the bottom will shoot at you too. But if you can hit him with the drill enough times, you will easily kill him way before he kills you. Especially if you can land multiple hits per drill. Victory at last. Finally, the nightmare is over. And I can get the fuck out of here and download some robot pornography. It's gonna be a good night. So now, stage two. So, instead of that giant, I guess it was like a, I don't know, like a an elephant-type robot. Instead of that, we would have fought Vile, which would have been way easier. But I like to kill all the bosses and access, you know, all of the bosses. I think it's more interesting. It's more satisfying. I'm demonstrating it to you. How much shit is in this game. Which, by the way, if you didn't kill the bosses, or, like, you can kill the optional bosses, and you'll still have to fight them again if you didn't kill them specifically with the weapon that they're weak against. So, you can go through all that effort, which I have multiple times, and still doesn't mean a damn thing. So, yeah. Really specific. And I didn't even know until I had to look all that shit up. So here we got another underwater portion, which it's going to be completely useless for this fucking thing, because it moves like crap, you can't jump worth a shit, can't do a jump dash, and there's pits everywhere. So, and I'm hitting the button, I don't even know I can't make it happen again. Yeah, it's gone. That happens every time I play. I try to do it and see, maybe I can get it on this try, but it's all wishful thinking. Oh, another thing. Like I was talking about, all the chip upgrades. So the helmet gives you life, and the armor gives you extra damage reduction, and the blaster decreases weapon usage. But the boots are the most important. If you didn't know to get the gold armor hidden sphinx down there, then you would definitely want to get. Just had to get one. You definitely want to get the boots. They are mandatory. For a lot of reasons. One, because they're fucking awesome. Oh, come on, man. Luckily, your regular attack sucks balls. But special attacks, like the spinning blades, are fucking brutal. So, he died in like 2 or 3 shots. Otherwise, I was dead. That dude does a fucking ridiculous amount of damage, and I don't know why. Also, open the door with my ass. I love it every time. It's so great. They should have more games where you can open doors with your ass. That's my favorite part. That should be like Resident Evil. You know, instead of creeping through the door slowly and cautiously, just open the knob with your ass. I'm sure we'd all pay for that Jill Valentine and Rebecca Chambers DLC. Make it happen, Capcom. Or really don't. I'm sick of seeing your face. But that's a different story. So, you wouldn't get the boot upgrade. If you had to get one upgrade in the game, it'd be the boots. Because you get the double air dash. Which is as awesome as it sounds. You could jump. You could do a dash jump up. And then do a dash jump up again. Which is insanity. Of every proportions. And really, it doesn't come into play very much. But the one spot it does come into play is so important that, yeah. You're not gonna regret it. So, I hate this. This is probably my least favorite part of the entire game. And there's me demonstrating the double air dash. To climb these snails, and they're really slow because they're snails. And you have to jump on here just right. If you touch the spike wall, it's the death, obviously. And guys are shooting missiles at you just to make sure that the tension is there. Because it wasn't there before. I was like, oh, I'm cool, bro. Just jumping across like 50 miles an hour. I won't hit the wall and die instantly. I'll hit this fucking VHS tape-sized little platform. I'll be cool. I won't fall down at the bottom of the pit and do it all over again. So then you add these guys with the fucking shooting rockets at me. Just in case the tension was a good one. So I'm almost to the end. And I'm probably not even going to give a fuck on this last one. I think I'm just going to fucking bypass it. Yeah. Double air dash at its finest. So that was a really useful application. But it gets even more useful when you get to the final boss. You're going to see what I'm talking about. Because the final boss, it's all about dodging. If you can't dodge, you're fucked. And what better way to dodge than to jump in the air at will? So, this is like the third time I've ever fought this boss in my life. But, he's not so bad. Just trying to figure out what his weakness is. Where his weak spot is, I don't remember. I think it's his big ass head. Oh. Well. Let's see. Let's try a variety of stuff here. I did a few fame points. That's not very effective. Let's go back to this. Okay. Something's gotta work. Nope. How about... Oh. Alright, no. I'm not really paying attention to this guy. He's shooting a bunch of shit at me. Seems to be very well equipped. A lot of firepower. I think I ever fought him this way. Just sitting here, he just seems to be spamming that one stupid attack that's really easy to dodge. I think I might have found a loophole here. Of course, the one aquatic boss would be weak to ice. I guess that kind of makes sense. But really, with how badass most of the weapons in this game are, it would make sense for them to be weak against pretty much all of them. So, I don't know. Except maybe the Ray Sparkler. I don't know how you can be killed by lights.